Hello everyone, my name's Cal, and in today's tutorial we're going to be building a pop-up style date picker in Swift and Xcode. More specifically, we're going to be creating a text field that when you select on it, it gives you a keyboard which is a date picker rather than some text. And when the user selects a date, we're going to put it back into the text field. It's a simple tutorial today, so let's get started. Creating a new Swift and Xcode project. This is an iOS app I'm building. I'm just going to call this date picker tutorial. Our programming language is Swift and our interface is Storyboard. I'm just going to hit create. And then the first thing we're going to do is head into our main storyboard. I'm going to drag in a text field. As well, above that, we're going to drag in a label. We're just going to give our label some constraints. So top space to the safe area and center horizontally. I'm going to right click and drag onto our label, just giving it vertical spacing and center horizontally. As well, we're going to give it equal widths to the container. We're going to click on our label and just make the font size a little bigger. As well, just adjusting the vertical constraints to both be 30. We're going to click on our text field. We're going to make the proportional width equal to 0.8 so that it takes up 80% of the screen. Next, we're going to make the font size a little bigger for our text field, as well as center aligning the text. And then we just want to change our text of our label to be select date. And that's all of the layout we're going to do. We're just going to quickly open up the assistant editor, right click and drag from the text field above our view did load, and then create an outlet for our date text field. We can close off the assistant editor now and head into our view controller Swift file. Inside our view did load, we're going to say let date picker equal to UI date picker. Date picker mode is equal to, and you can see there's a few different options here. I'm just going to choose date for this tutorial, but there's no reason you couldn't make a date and time picker, just depending on usage. And then we're going to say date picker.addTarget. Target we're going to pass through self. Our action selector we're going to do a hash symbol and then type selector. And then we're going to create an Objective-C function calling it date change, which receives a date picker. Hit enter for UI control event and then just choose value changed. So every time that the date picker changes, we're going to run this function. So we're just going to create an Objective-C function calling it date change, which takes a UI date picker. And we'll come back to this function, but for now we're going to continue on with our date picker. We're just going to say date picker frame size is equal to CG size, giving it a width of 0 and a height of 300. We're going to say date picker preferred date style, and you can see there's a few different options here. I'm going to choose wheels for this tutorial. However, it could be worth having a play around with some of the different styles to see if there's one you like better. Next, we just need to assign our date picker to our date text field. So we're just going to say date text field dot input view is equal to our date picker, and then we're going to create a function that's going to turn our date into a string that we can display to the user, calling it format date, which receives a date and returns a string. We're going to say let formatter equal to date formatter. Formatter date format is equal to, we're going to give it 4 capital M's, 2 D's and 4 Y's. So that is a text month, days and years date format. And then we're going to return formatter string from date, giving it our date. And then from our date change, we're just going to say date text field dot text is equal to format date, giving it our date picker date. And then we can copy and paste that and just giving it date, which is actually today's date. So we're going to initialize our text field with today's date. Let's build and run this now and see if we've got a working date picker. Cool. And if we click on the text field, you can see the pop-up date picker has appeared at the bottom of the screen. And when you select a date, whichever date is selected is the one that's showing in our text field. One other thing I'll quickly show you is if you want to set a max or min date, you just need to say date picker.maximum date is equal to, and I'm just giving it today's date. And you can see that when you scroll through, you can't actually select a date into the future. Set minimum date works exactly the same. I hope you enjoyed the Swift and Xcode tutorial, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.